പരിശുദ്ധാത്മാവിന്റെ അത്ഭുതകരമായ സാന്നിധ്യം ഇപ്പോൾ ഈ കൂടാരം മുഴുവനും നിറയട്ടെ.
The same power coming upon you, upon you.
To heaven by closing our eyes, remember I am raising my hands towards my Father in heaven. He is very close to me. I am lifting my heart to the Father in heaven. I am going to call upon his name. I am going to ask the Lord to forgive me, to bless me, to anoint me, to deliver me, to heal me. I want to be blessed by my Father in heaven, because he is the one who formed me in my mother's womb, in his image and in his likeness, in his resemblance he formed me. Oh my Father in heaven, Abba, Abba Father, Abba, you are my Father, you are my Father, you are the one who formed me. Many times I rejected you in my life. Now I come to you. Now I come to you. You are my God. You are my Lord. You are my God. I ask for your mercy. I ask for your mercy. I ask you to come into my life. Come into my life, O Lord. There is no one to take care of me. There is no one to understand me. There is no one to love me. I come to you, my Father, asking for your mercy. How mercy on me? How mercy on me? I can't bear this burden in my life. I can't bear this burden. I can't bear these problems in my life. There is no one to help me. I come to you by lifting up my heart and my hands to you. I ask you, Father, to touch my life, to come into my life. Send out your word and deliver me from this destruction. I want to be saved. I want to be redeemed. How mercy on me. Let us open our mouth Let us praise and worship Him. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We praise you, Father. We praise you, Father. Hallelujah. 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 Wisdom of Solomon, chapter 6, verse 10. We read, "For they will be made holy who observe holy things in holiness."
Pragya Granth, 6th अध्याय 10th वचन, जो पवित्र नियमों का श्रद्धा पूर्वक पालन करते हैं वे पवित्र माने जाएंगे और जो उन नियमों का शिक्षा ग्रहण करेंगे वे उनके आधार पर अपनी सफाई दे सकेंगे.
So this after me, for they will be made holy who observe holy things in holiness.
इसको कहिए हमारे साथ में, जो पवित्र नियमों का श्रद्धा पूर्वक पालन करते हैं वे पवित्र माने जाएंगे.
Hallelujah. See, the word teaches that if you want to be holy, the word says that you observe holy things in holiness. We can be holy, do everything in holiness. So we have to learn what is holiness and what is unholiness. We have to discern that. When we live in this world, it is very difficult to keep holiness. But it is not much difficult if we read the word, if we study the word, if we keep the word, it is very easy. See, the word is given by the living God. It is not made by any human beings. God is asking us to keep it. And God knows that we are helpless. We are too weak. We have no power to keep the word. So He will give us the power to keep the word, to protect the word, to live in the word. Not by any human actions we can't obey the word. We need heavenly support. That is what we get through the Holy Spirit. If we have the relation, a close relation with God, a deep relation with God, every time by pouring out His Spirit into our heart, He strengthens us. He gives us courage and power to resist the enemy, to go away from sin, to resist sin and to keep the word. So remember that the word is given by God, the Holy Spirit is given by God, everything is in us. We have to use that. We have to pray to the Holy Spirit, give me the strength, the power to resist sin. Give me the power to keep the word. Of course, it will be given to you. Otherwise, no use of teaching the word. If you want to be in holiness, because God is holy, He knew we are living in a world of sin and darkness, we have to fight. The fight is this: receiving the power of the Holy Spirit, praying with through the Holy Spirit. Again and again, we have to get more power we need to get. And by using that power, we can resist the enemy. The Holy Spirit will help us to keep the word.
प्रभु जानते हैं, प्रलोभनों से भरे हुए इस दुनिया में मनुष्यों को अकेले इस प्रलोभनों का सामना करना बेहद मुश्किल है. मनुष्य दुर्बल है, लेकिन प्रभु कहते हैं कि मेरे शब्दों का तुम अपने जीवन में अनुपालन करो, मैं तुम्हें पवित्र आत्मा दूंगा. वचन प्रभु का है, पवित्र आत्मा प्रभु की है. हमें केवल याचना करना है और हम जो शक्ति, जो पवित्रता, जो बल का हम उपयोग करना चाहते हैं वो प्रभु हमको देंगे. इसीलिए आप सदा वचनों के अनुसार अपना जीवन बिताइए और आप में पवित्रता बनी रहेगी और आप दुश्मन का मुकाबला करने के लिए सबल हो जाएंगे.
So let us use the weapons given to us to resist the devil.
हमको दिए गए हथियारों का प्रयोग करें ताकि हम हमारे दुश्मन को मार भगा सकें.
I have told many times that the most powerful weapon given to us in the word is the weapon that we read in the book of Matthew 16:19.
मैंने आपसे हमेशा कहा है कि हमको जो सबसे शक्तिशाली हथियार प्रभु ने हमको दिया है वो संत मत्ती का सुसमाचार 16वां अध्याय 19वां वचन है.
Jesus says that, I'll give you the keys of the kingdom of heaven. And whatever you bind on earth will be bound in heaven. And whatever you loose on earth will be loosed in heaven.
Yeshu कहते हैं, मैं स्वर्ग की चाबी तुम्हारे हाथ में देता हूँ. तुम जो धरती पर बांधोगे, वो स्वर्ग में बांधा जाएगा. जो तुम धरती पर खोलोगे, वो स्वर्ग में खोल दिया जाएगा.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
So that power is given to us to bind and to loose. He says that whatever you loose bind on earth, it will be bound in heaven. And whatever you loose on earth, it will be loosed in heaven. That means that everything I say, God is there to support me, to fulfill it. He's there. He's supporting us. God, He is not doing that. He is not binding anything. Power is given to us. So He says that whatever you bind, that means it is your responsibility to bind your enemy. Who is our enemy? Who is our enemy? The devil. It comes different ways. Suppose the enemy may come through our own family members, through our neighbors. Suppose someone, the neighbor, makes some problem. You are so irritated. What do? You go to the police station. That is what normally happens. Or you go to someone for a commendation, political leaders. See, Lord says that, I have given you the weapon. If the neighbor is irritating you, you have to realize that it is not him. It is the devil who is trying to create problems through that person in your life. So it is the devil behind everything. What you have to do is that, take the weapon. You pray to the Lord. Lord, my neighbor, I know he is your child. But he is led by the evil powers. He is trying to create many problems in my life. I am so irritated. I am so troubled, Lord. I am so worried. Please come for my help. And you have to say, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, I bind that devil who is trying to create problems in my life. I bind it by the word of Matthew 16:19. Whatever you bind on earth will be bound in heaven. The Holy Spirit is there to make it fulfill, to make it flesh. If it is not happening, no use of giving this word. I like to tell you, every day we have to do that. Early morning, after getting up, after your prayers, you have to say, you devil, the evil powers, those who are going to come today against me, I bind them the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Why can't you say that? You are putting the enemy in prison by saying that. Because the devil have many plans against you that day. He is going to create. Before he create, make any problem, you have to say, in the name of Jesus Christ, I bind every evil spirits, every evil powers, those who are going to create problems in my life today, I bind you by the word, Matthew 16:19. I command you all to surrender and go to the feet of Jesus Christ. Why can't you say that? No problem in saying that. You are making your own protection. Immediately I tell you, the Holy Spirit, come down there in your life. Because you will be very happy, my child. Using the weapon, fighting against the devil, immediately the angels will come to for your guard, to for your protection. Sure. In such a way, when the devil tries to put the seed of sin in our heart, the seed of hatred against the family members or against the neighbors, against anyone, when he tries to put that seed of hatred in your heart, very careful. Don't go after that. If you go after that seed in your heart, it's very easy for the devil to possess you, to possess your heart. The heart is filled with the hatred against that person. You lose all your relations with that person. He will be your number one enemy. Remember, it is the work of the devil. Whatever things that person has done in your life, whatever it is, give it to the Lord. You have no permission to take revenge against anyone. It is not given to you. The word says that, don't take revenge I'm going to say anyone, give it to the Lord. It is He. He will take care of that.
तुम जो धरती पर बांधोगे वो स्वर्ग में बांधा जाएगा, तुम धरती पर जो खोलोगे वो स्वर्ग में खोला जाएगा। जैसे आपके कहने पर आपका वचन स्वर्ग में पूरा हो जाता है। प्रभु स्वयं ये वचन उठाकर नहीं बोलते हैं, लेकिन आपके वचन के साथ में वो जुड़ जाते हैं, वो आपका सहारा बनते हैं और आपका वचन फल बनकर उसका रूप धारण करके धरती पर आप उसको देख सकते हैं। आपका रोज की प्रार्थना सुबह करने के बाद में आपके उस दिन में आपको सताने के लिए आने वाले शैतान को आप बांध क्यों नहीं देते? आध्यात्मिक जीवन में आने के बाद में परिवार का सदस्य, पड़ोसी, कोई भी किसी के भी द्वारा शैतान आपको सताने, आपके सामने रोड़े अटकाने के लिए खड़ा हो जाता है। इसीलिए आप अपने प्रार्थनाओं के बाद में कहिए, आज के दिन मेरे जीवन में प्रवेश करने वाले शैतान, मैं तुझको संत मत्ती के अध्याय 16:19 वचन के द्वारा मैं तुझको बांध देता हूँ। और देखिए, ऐसे करने के साथ में ही पवित्र आत्मा आपकी मदद के लिए आएगी, देवदूतगण आपकी मदद के लिए आएंगे और आप सुरक्षित रहेंगे और इसके द्वारा आप अपनी पवित्रता भी बनाए रख सकेंगे, प्रभु के वचनों के अनुसार आप जी भी सकेंगे।
Book of Romans chapter 12 verse 19, there we read that, beloved, never avenge yourselves, but leave room for the wrath of God, for it is written, vengeance is mine, I will repay, says the Lord. So if your enemies are hungry, feed them. If they are thirsty, give them something to drink. For by doing this, you will heap burning coals on their heads. Do not be overcome by evil, but overcome evil with good.
जो आपके जीवन में परेशानियां पैदा करता है, आप उसे नफरत मत कीजिए, उसे बदला मत लीजिए। प्रभु कहते हैं, बदला लेने का काम मेरे हवाले कर दो, बदला के करना तुम्हारा अधिकार नहीं है। रोमियो के नाम संत पॉल का पत्र 12 अध्याय 19 वचन में ऐसे कहा गया है, प्रिय भाइयों, अपना आप स्वयं बदला न चुकाएं, बल्कि उसे ईश्वर के प्रकोप पर छोड़ दें, क्योंकि लिखा है, प्रभु कहते हैं, प्रतिशोध मेरा अधिकार है, मैं ही बदला चुकाऊंगा। इसलिए यदि आपका शत्रु भूखा है तो उसे खिलाएं, यदि वह प्यासा है तो उसे पानी पिलाएं, क्योंकि ऐसा करने से आप उसके सिर पर जलते अंगारों का ढेर लगाएंगे।
हालेलुया,
हालेलुया।
See, the Holy Spirit is asking us to forgive everyone. If they do wrong against you, you have to forgive. By doing this, you will heap burning coals on their heads.
पवित्र आत्मा यहाँ पर हमको ये सिखा रही है कि हम किसी से भी घृणा नहीं करें, किसी से भी प्रतिशोध ना लें, बल्कि हमारे शत्रु को भी हम मदद करें जब उसकी ज़रूरत है। तब ऐसे करने से हम उसके सिर पर अनुताप, पश्चाताप का अंगार डालेंगे।
See, we have no right to take revenge against anyone. Don't pray, Lord, you take revenge against them. Don't pray like that. That is wrong.
हम किसी से बदला ना लें और न ही ऐसा प्रार्थना करें कि प्रभु मेरे जगह में आप उससे बदला लीजिए। ये प्रार्थना गलत है।
So let us forgive to others. That is what the Lord teaches us.
और इस वजह से प्रभु ने जैसे सिखाया है, हम वैसे ही करें कि हम सभी से प्रेम का संबंध रखें।
And remember, when the devil tries to put the seed of hatred in your heart, you should be very careful. You have to realize that it is from the devil. So what you have to do is that first you forgive that person, then you have to command in your heart, I bind and rebuke the seed of hatred from my heart. I rebuke it in the name of the Lord. That is what the Lord says, that to uproot a seed of sin, to pluck it from your heart, take it out of your heart, you will be free. Otherwise, if it is there, a seed is there, it's a very good chance for easy for the devil to have his dominion in your life. Your heart will be filled with that poison, hatred. Then you go and pray. God will be helpless in your life. But God says that, Jesus says that, the power is given to you. Do not be become a slave of the devil. The devil is there to create problems in your life every time. Come out of this. Use the weapon. Resist the devil. You will be free. And the Spirit of God will be there in your heart every time to help you.
जब आपके मन में किसी के प्रति नफरत का या घृणा का कोई विचार आता है तो सावधान हो जाइए. अपने मन में ऐसे नफरत के विचारों को जगह मत दीजिए. यदि आप तभी के तभी आपको समझना चाहिए ये शत्रु आपके खिलाफ अपना राज्य यहाँ पर आपके मन में फैला रहा है. उसी समय प्रभु ने जो आपको अधिकार दिया है उस अधिकार का प्रयोग करके उस घृणा के बीज को जड़ पकड़ने के पहले ही उखाड़ कर फेंकिए. वचन का प्रयोग कीजिए और शैतान को धुतकारिए अपने जीवन में से. जब तक आप ऐसा नहीं करेंगे शैतान आपके मन में अपना राज्य फैलाता रहेगा. आप उसके गुलाम बनते जाएंगे और उसके बाद में यदि आप प्रार्थना भी करें तो प्रभु असहाय होंगे आपकी मदद करने के लिए. इसीलिए बिल्कुल वीरता के साथ में अधिकार के साथ में प्रभु के दिए हुए हथियार का प्रयोग कीजिए और दुश्मन का मुकाबला करके उसको भगाइए.
I remember one young man in Kerala. And he was a problem maker. He was, means he is the head of the rowdies, Dada. But anyway, many prayed for him. He changed his life. He came for the retreat. Then he started to lead a holy life. He left every politics, everything he left. Before coming about the retreat into faith, he frightened everyone that village. Our place, Surinili. He frightened many people there. By hearing his name, everyone frightened. That was that person. But coming to Jesus, he stopped everything. Once he was in the market, he was beaten by some other fellows. No one dared to raise their hands against him before. But after coming to the Lord, after starting to lead a holy life, he was beaten by some other people. And it was the same for him. Never, no one dared to do such thing in his life in all these years. Now I am the Lord. Lord, these people, see, I am beaten by them. He rushed to the church. This is a very, very nearby church. Church was closed. He knelt down there on the steps of the church and he started to cry. And he said, Lord, I forgive to them. All these years I was beating many people, have beaten many people here. But now, Lord, I forgive to them and you also forgive to them. First I felt it is the same for me because I am beaten by those people. But I forgive them, Lord. You bless them, Lord. In such a way he was praying. And he told me he was there for half an hour. Within this half an hour, he hear cries and loud voices from the near city. He can see people going, running here and there. Many are making loud voices. He went down there and he saw the person half an hour before who beat this one. He was beaten by some other people like beating a dog. He was lying on the ground and those people were doing whatever they can do against that person. It is not because of this reason. They doesn't know anything about this. This one was praying there in the church. Some other problem came up. Some family problems came up there. He went there to comfort the people. Actually, it was a surprise for me. This young man, see, he changed his life and he came to Jesus Christ. The devil tried to irritate him, but he left it to God. Immediately God intervened in his life. He heard that by doing this, you will heap burning coals on their heads. See, when we forgive the name of the Lord, we are putting the burning coals over their head. It is not to destroy them, but to for their repentance. They have to change their life. Remember, we have no right to take revenge against anyone. Forgive to everyone. By forgiving to others, you are making the kingdom of God in their hearts. So let us ask the Lord for the grace to forgive others, and also remember, let us use the weapon. Do not allow the devil to control your life, to possess your life, to possess your thoughts. Destroy him. Bind him by using the word, by the power. Immediately the Holy Spirit will come there. He will uproot that seed of sin from your heart, and within seconds your heart will be free.
जब मैं प्रभु का वचन आपको ये सुना रहा हूँ, इसी के साथ में मैं आपको एक उदाहरण भी देना चाहूँगा कि हमारे गांव सूर्यनली में एक नौजवान नेता था, वो गुंडों का सरगना भी था, वो उसने उस गांव को डरा के रखा हुआ था, सभी लोग उसके नाम से कांपते थे, ऐसे उसके दुर्व्यवहार से गांव थक गया था, ऐसे में कई लोगों की प्रार्थना, हमारी भी प्रार्थना प्रभु के पास पहुंची और वो धीरे धीरे उसका मन परिवर्तन हुआ, वो प्रभु के विश्वास में आया, उसने राजनीति छोड़ दी और वो एक पवित्रता का जीवन जीने लगा। ऐसे में एक दिन वो हमारा सूर्यनली का गांव जो है वो पहाड़ी इलाका है, वो ऊंचाई की तरफ वहाँ पे एक गिरजा भी है और नीचे की तरफ बाज़ार है। बाज़ार में एक दिन उसका एक दुश्मन उसे मिला और उसने किसी कारणवश उसको बुरी तरह से पीटा। उसके मन में यदि वो चाहता था तो उसको उल्टा मार सकता था, लेकिन वो मार खाने के बाद में मन से दुखी और शर्म से मिट्टी में गड़ा हुआ वो आदमी दौड़कर वो गिरजे में गया। गिरजा बंद था, लेकिन गिरजे की सीढ़ियों पर घुटने टेक कर वो रो रो कर उसने प्रार्थना किया कि प्रभु, जिसने मेरे साथ ये दुर्व्यवहार किया है, मैं उसको माफ़ करता हूँ, आप भी उसको माफ़ कीजिए। इस प्रार्थना में करीबन आधा घंटा बीता। ऐसे में उसको नीचे बाजार की तरफ जोरों का एक शोरगुल सुनाई दिया और जब उसने देखा तो वो ये पाता है कि जिस व्यक्ति ने उसे आधे घंटे पहले मारा था, दूसरे किसी कारणवश दूसरे कई लोग आके उसको इतनी बुरी तरह से पीटे हैं जैसे कि वो किसी कुत्ते को पीट रहे हैं, और वो वहाँ खून से नहाया हुआ पड़ा हुआ है। मैं आपसे ये कहना चाहता हूँ कि किसी से आप प्रतिशोध मत लीजिए, बदला मत लीजिए और एक पवित्रता का जीवन जिए। प्रभु आपको जो अधिकार दिया है उस अधिकार का प्रयोग कीजिए। जब शैतान आपके मन में नफरत, घृणा, बदला लेने के भाव यदि आपके मन में पैदा करता है तो शैतान को आप धुतकार कर भगाइए। आपको जो अधिकार दिया है उसका प्रयोग कीजिए और प्रतिशोध प्रभु के हाथ में दे दीजिए, और ऐसे करने से ही ये वचन सत्य हो जाता है कि आपकी भलाई के द्वारा आपके दुश्मन के मन में आप पश्चाताप का बीज बोएंगे, वो उसके मन परिवर्तन का कारण बनेगा।
हालेलुया,
हालेलुया।